Thank you very much for taking the time to review the L9 Component Manager. In this video, we're going to walk through the installation process. So what we're going to do is we're going to start on the library9.com website. You can see that over here. And in order for us to download and get everything set up, we need to download that information from the library9 site here. You do need to have a login in order to do that. And if you do not have a login, please do contact us here at 9.connects. So I'm going to go through the process of logging in so we can get to the download page here. So clicked on login, my access information is there, and so I'm going to press login. And you'll notice that we go immediately to the download area here, and there are two key features of importance. The first one is your license key, which you can see over here. You'll have one that's different than mine. You'll want to select that, right-click, and copy it, because we'll need it definitely later on when we are finished with our initial setup. You'll notice down over here that we have four files of interest, three of which are PDFs. The only one that I think that you'll need to take a look at prior to really starting this effort is the system requirements, just to make sure that your systems have what is necessary in order to make this work here. The other two, the install instructions and the installation of the purchase key, you should have those. However, if everything goes according to the way this video has been set up, you should be able to follow along and be ready to go by the time this video is done. But if you have a different configuration or circumstance, it is still good to have those two PDFs. What we're going to be interested in is the zip file here. And so we're going to download that because that's our executable. So I'm going to start that download at this point in time. And I'm going to pause it so that you don't have to go through the motions of watching it download. All right, you can see here now that I have it downloaded. And in addition to that, I've already unzipped it. I have put this on my desktop here. You can see that the top level name is L9 Demo. You can see after that, we have this directory called L9_V_1_0. That is the name of the zip that was sent down. I just simply extracted it out at this point to save a little bit of time. So when I double click into this directory here, you can see a number of different things. The one that we're most interested in is the L9Manager.exe. Now, I should make note that you can pretty much put this anywhere you want in your directory system. However, the file names and the directory names cannot have any white space in it or it will not work. So I just want to give you that particular heads up. In this case, I'm simply just going to run it from the desktop. Now, this is not an install type of program. You don't click on it and you go through this whole installation wizard. It only runs when you execute it, and that's what I'm going to do here right now. So with the L9 Manager, I'm going to double click it. You'll see a little bit of that infinite circle of patience zip around a few times, and then nothing seems to come up. Well, what's happening? Well, it did start. However, if we look down at the very bottom right of our server tray over here, we will see the logo L9. And I'm going to right-click on this, and I'm going to open the browser. So it is running. It's just simply we need to gain access to what's running through a browser window. So I'm going to click on Open Browser, and this now brings up my browser here. Since this is brand new, we are going to create the account. So I'm going to click on Create Account at this point in time. So the company name here is, we're going to put in 9.connects, and I'll autofill this over here. And my name here being Paul Taubman. I've got our email here at paul@9.connects.com with my username will be Paul, and I can make it anything else that I want, and I'll provide my password. And of course, we need to verify. That's it. That's all I need to do. So at this point in time, I'm just establishing the company name and I'm establishing myself as one of the administrators. So that's all we need to do at this point. And I'm going to click on register. It comes back and it says that the account has been created. So I'm going to press return. Okay, once we press the return button, you'll see that we return to the login page. So now with our newly created login, we're going to put that login and password in there. And once we get in there, you'll notice that the very first thing that L9 is going to request you or prompt you for is your license key. So as mentioned earlier, you'll want to have that in your copy buffer. And at that point in time, when you have it, you can simply click in there, right click and do paste, and you'll be able to drop in your license key and press. And at that point in time, L9 is good to go. Now let's take a brief tour of the L9 package as you see it in front of you here. One of the key buttons that you see is in the top left corner. That is the icon, but it is also the button that you can use to always go to the top level of the L9 system. You'll also notice in the middle, an area that's a little bit sparse here, but this is where your categories are going to be. So if you create different component categories, which we'll talk about in another video, you'll be able to find those over here. They'll all be listed. You can click into them to see various categories that you may have already set up. On the very top of the page there, you'll see the company name, which we entered in when we did the initial setup. You can see my name as the logged in user. You can also see my administrative status as well. And there are two other statuses. There's librarian status, and there is also the user status as well. And in another video, we'll go into what those statuses allow and do not allow. But effectively, the admin has pretty much free rein over any aspect of the tool itself. Just keep in mind that once you've got a flow set up here, changes that you make could have a monumental impact on the flow that people are already using. So just keep that in mind. And of course, the internet status is connected. We'll need that in a little bit, especially when we do an update to the L9 here, which I'll show here in just a moment. All right, on the left side, you'll see a couple of menus here. The one that I'm going to focus in on is the My Account menu here. You'll see that there are two pieces of information, the account information itself and the admin area. If I click into the account information area, you can see all the information we put in initially when we first set things up. If I want to change my administrative information, I can certainly do that over here, at least in terms of my password. I'm not going to do that at this point in time. If I want to go back to a higher directory, all these pages do have a little return button in the top right corner. When I click on that, it will bring me to the top level. In the My Accounts page, there is also the admin area as well. And this is something I have access to because of my admin status. There's user management, library management, and there is system management. We're going to focus in on the system management page. So I'm going to click on that here. We've already taken care of the license key. What we do want to do now is to do a system update. Okay, so let's click on that here. We can see that our current version was the base version that was initially released, but what we want to bring down is the newest version, which happens to be 1.5.1 as of the recording of this particular video. So if I want to update this, it's not a problem. I simply need to hit the update system. So L9, because of my internet status being connected, is going right now to the L9.com webpage. It has taken that information and has successfully updated according to this particular dialog. So I'm going to press OK, and we're good to go at this point. You'll see that there's a refresh. You'll now see that the current version and the newest version are both 1.5.1. So we're all good to go on that. Let's go back to the My Accounts admin area again, and let's go back into system management. So we've taken care of the system update, we've taken care of the license key. The next thing that we want to do is we want to click on the Octo Part API key. And this one is a really important thing to add on here. We do not provide this particular API. This is something that you can get from Octo Part. And the reason why you want to have this for your company is that anytime somebody puts in a manufacturer's part number, this allows L9 to go over to Octo Part through the API and pull the information in automatically. So it's a lot easier and it's a lot more formatted than if you were to manually type it in yourself. So that is what I'm going to put in over here. So I'm going to put in my API for OctoPart and again, press submit. Very similar to the way we will do the license key. Those are the key things that we need in order to set up at this point in time. So in our next video, what I'm going to do is show how to set up the categories in order for us to put components into the L9 library component system. Thank you very much.